This weekend, 350 asylum seekers flown in from the southern border boarded buses to Chicago after landing in Rockford, Illinois. Their transportation north, arranged by Texas Governor Greg Abbott. Chicago Mayor Brandon Johnson said on Face the Nation, city officials were given no notice.
The rogue buses that are being dropped off across this country in the middle of the night, leaving people with no real support at all, no coordination with the local municipalities, that type of chaos is certainly dividing our country.
A record high of hundreds of thousands of migrants entered the United States in December, and there are no signs that this crisis is slowing down as thousands of asylum seekers arrive at major cities across the country. We're talking Chicago, Denver, New York City. Community members in these cities have been furious about the situation, but they're not the only ones. Let's watch.
Chicago is just one city dealing with the influx and now cracking down on buses bringing in migrants without advance notice. Last week, New York City Mayor Eric Adams issued an emergency order to restrict bus arrivals, but that hasn't stopped busloads of migrants now being dropped off at train stations in New Jersey with easy access to the city. Adams says the migrant crisis will cost New York $12 billion by 2025. This comes as the U.S. Border Patrol manages a record migrant surge. Agents are processing 250,000 new arrivals each month in December, hitting an all-time high of 300,000 migrants.
That number absolutely blew me away. 300,000 migrants coming into the United States in just 1 month. As CBS News also reports, U.S. Border Patrol agents took into custody more than 225,000 migrants who crossed the southern border in between official crossings during the first 27 days of December. And that's according to the preliminary Department of Homeland Security statistics. The figure does not include legal entries at ports of entry, where the Biden administration has been processing roughly 50,000 migrants each month, mostly under a process powered by a smartphone app. And nearly 60% of all migrants processed by Border Patrol in December crossed into the United States illegally in the remote Tucson, Arizona, and Del Rio, Texas sectors, where officials have recorded between 2,000 and 3,000 unlawful crossings each day, according to the internal DHS data. So when you hear reports about how Border Patrol is inundated and overwhelmed by the influx of migrants, that does appear to be true. In both regions, migrants have found themselves sleeping outdoors near international bridges or border barriers because Border Patrol is basically lacking the manpower and resources to process everyone in a timely fashion. And in response, New York Mayor Eric Adams has issued an executive order to essentially attempt to restrict the flow of migrants coming into New York City. It's really important to get into the details of that and the loopholes that have been implemented to get around it. Before we do though, Cenk, thoughts on the numbers of migrants coming in?
So my number one thought is it's real. So we've shown you on the show many, many times in the past when Fox News, Republicans, Donald Trump, et cetera, overhype things and they'd show you a caravan and they'd be like, oh my God, the caravans are coming, right? And are there still things that are overhyped about this particular wave? Sure, like the absurd claim that Hamas and terrorists are part of the immigrants.
No, it's crazy.
It's lunatic things. But you don't, right wingers, you don't need that. Because this time it's actually real. The numbers are much larger than they used to be. And so that's true. And so our job is to be honest with you guys, not pick political sides and go, okay, well, it's inconvenient for the left for it to be true. It is true, okay? So now number two, as you know, I said from day one that busing made sense. It made political sense, and to some degree, it even makes policy sense. So why should the border states have all of the pain? So they shared the pain with the rest of the country. That doesn't mean that I'm against immigration. I'll get to that part of it in a second. But I do think that there's no reason why Chicago, New York, and all these other cities shouldn't share the pain of the border states. And so that we can get a national policy that makes sense for all of us, including the immigrants.
The only way you're gonna get immigration reform and the two political sides working together is if the two political sides acknowledge that our immigration system is in fact broken and we need to compromise with one another to come up with solutions to deal with this. My issue is that Congress really has no interest in any type of immigration reform. All they do is point fingers to Biden. Biden takes all the blame. In reality, legislation comes from Congress, and so they need to actually do their jobs and provide legislative reforms that we can work with here. They're doing none of that. So that's a huge problem. But at the same time, I want to just quickly go back to the allegations that Hamas is entering the southern border. I do believe that that's fear mongering. There's no evidence of that. However, if you have 250,000 migrants coming into the country, entering the country illegally, we don't know who's entering the country.
Yeah,
right?
I hear you.
There
on
is
that,
an issue there.
But Anna, as we've discussed before, stats show, at least in the past, that even undocumented immigrants commit crime at half the rate of natural born citizens.
No, I totally understand that. And that is true of studies that were done in the past. But what we're experiencing now is unlike anything we've experienced before when it comes to.
Yeah, but I'm not getting. So are there gonna be some bad guys across the border? Of course, because there's bad guys in any random 250,000 group of people.
But just
right?
Listen to what I'm saying really quick, Cenk. I'm not trying to defame all the migrants coming in. I think the majority of them are probably just coming in because they're fleeing for their lives. It's unsafe in their countries. They want economic opportunities. I'm not saying that they're dangerous, okay? But again, if you have a situation in which you don't have proper personnel, a proper number of people kind of processing people as they come in, that is a problem. That is a problem.
Yeah, I totally agree. So look, there's two answers to this, but they're gonna be unpopular, and that's part of why they're not discussing real answers. So one is send in an army of judges to get through the asylum process much, much quicker. And if you were able to do it quickly enough, you could actually keep the people that crossed over there instead of releasing them into America, where most of them come back for the trials, but some don't, right? So that's issue number one, but that costs money, so the Republicans are gonna say no. And the Democrats aren't even gonna propose it, right? Although to be fair to Biden, he has increased the number of judges a lot, just not anywhere near the size that you need to handle the size of the problem. And then finally, you should do a Marshall Plan in Latin America, because the real problem is how many people are coming. You're never going to be able to intercept all of them at the border. You could have like the world's greatest wall and the greatest military ever, line them all up at the border, it's still not gonna work well enough to prevent enough people from, the border is just too large, right? You've gotta stop the problem at its source. And the way to do that is to do a Marshall Plan where people don't need to flee those countries. But that's not gonna be popular in America. And so the Republicans would despise it. Helping Latin Americans, they would think it's like the worst thing in the world. So they'd say non-starter. So there's no way they're gonna actually fix the problem. All we're gonna do is keep pointing fingers at one another for the rest of the time.
So during a recent presser, New York City Mayor Eric Adams decided to discuss an executive order that he has implemented. And that executive order basically requires bus operators to provide at least 32 hours advance notice of arrivals. These are the migrants that are coming in through buses, usually from Texas. And he also limited drop-off hours for the migrants. Now here's Adams during that recent presser explaining the situation.
We're seeing the erosion of the quality of life that we've improved on in such a short period of time of this administration. And we have been impacted. For many months, we were able to keep the visualization of this crisis from hitting our streets, but we have reached a breaking point. We're no longer able to do that because of the volume and numbers. Just last week, we had 3,900 people that arrived here. We are averaging anywhere from 2,500 to close to 4,000 a week. And if you do the math, you see that's 8,000 every 2 weeks, potentially 16,000 a month that we must feed, clothe, house, educate children, and all the services that you would give a normal adult. And we're seeing that play out on our streets of New York. And that is what the breaking point looks like, what we are experiencing right now.
Now, look, I'm not a huge fan of Eric Adams, but a lot of what he said there is true. New York City is struggling with housing people, feeding people, providing the resources necessary to take care of migrants as they're coming in. The situation is untenable and it's difficult to deal with. And they're frustrated at the lack of support from the federal government. They're calling for the Biden administration to provide more resources. But in regard to the executive order that's been implemented by Eric Adams, there's a major loophole, and the bus operators are already seizing on that loophole. According to Secaucus, New Jersey Mayor Michael Gonnelli, he says that the buses are now dropping migrants off at train stations throughout New Jersey, and then they board the trains and then just make their way to New York City as part of their final leg to New York City. He says, quote, "It seems quite clear the bus operators are finding a way to thwart the requirements of the executive order by dropping off migrants at the train station in Secaucus and having them continue to their final destination." He also said in a statement that he suggests that the order might actually be too stringent and it's resulting in unexpected consequences. He called the tactic a loophole bus operators have found to allow migrants to reach New York City, and added that state police have reported that this is now happening at train stations throughout the state. Gonnelli vowed to work with state and county officials to continue to monitor the situation closely. Listen, doing these little band-aids is not going to help the situation. I understand the frustration that the mayors of these major cities are experiencing right now. I definitely understand the frustration with the federal government, because at the end of the day, the federal government is tasked with dealing with our immigration policies and dealing with this issue overall. But at the same time, you're not gonna solve the problem by limiting the hours of the day that migrants can be dropped off in New York City. And I understand the need for the 32 hours advance notice. I wish that we lived in a perfect world where they were doing that, but clearly they're not doing that and they're just finding ways around it.
Yeah, one last serious point. But first, I have to note that Michael Gonnelli is the most New Jersey mayor sounding name there is.
Totally.
And second of all, I'm taking Mayor Adams seriously, even though he sounds exactly like Tracy Morgan. Okay, somebody's getting pregnant tonight. Anyways, that's a super old school joke. All right, now to the serious last point. Guys, look at them transferring the immigrants around like a hot potato.
I know.
Our government is so broken.
So broken.
We haven't done immigration reform in decades. So everybody's complaining about immigration. The border states are, now the major cities are, the blue states are, the red states are, the Republicans are, the Democrats are. But no one ever does anything because our government is irreversibly broken. They could be fixed if we just cleaned up politics and got money out of politics and went back to having an actual democracy. But as things stand now, people profit from the status quo. So they're never ever going to fix this. All they're going to do is transfer these poor people around to all the different cities and blame one another. It's disgusting.
One final thing I'll say about this, and it's really important to know this. There's also an interest in not doing anything about immigration, because there are business interests that want more labor. They've hated the fact that there's been a tight labor market, thus giving workers more leverage in negotiating for better pay and better benefits. And so bringing in more migrants, and look, what are Democrats and in some cases even Republicans calling for in response to the influx of migrants coming into the country? Let's rush the workers' visas. Let's rush the workers' visas. Workers, workers, workers. They want them to work in these jobs and essentially drive down wages for everyone, including the people who have had a little more leverage in this economy.
The only thing I'll say in response to that is 100.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.